This is Steve.
And this is Shawn.
Welcome to Acro Media Side 5.
So Steve, what are we going to talk about today?
Well, I thought it's about time to do a mini-series because Drupal 8's coming out, and or has come out.
Thank you.
And since that's the case, you know, there's a lot of cool features coming out, as I know that you've been bragging about since you are the biggest Drupal fanboy of all time. Would that be fair?
Seems unfair, but...
Okay. A large fanboy, but not the largest fanboy. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. That being said...
You're fat, but not the fattest.
Exactly.
So okay.
So, you know, we could probably talk about some of the features, and I know that you've picked out six that you want to talk about, so this could be the part one of a six-part miniseries. Does that sound okay?
Okie doke.
Right.
So we'll do part one on Bigpipe caching, which I know you have trouble saying.
Yes, Bagpipe caching is typically what I end up saying, but Bigpipe caching.
Got it. Jason, if you could actually just put the text up here, you know, somewhere, here, over here, maybe. Drupal 8 has a really cool thing that's called Bigpipe caching. Bigpipe you might be familiar with, not because you actually heard the term, but that's how Facebook loads content in. So if you're on Facebook, you'll see that it loads up sort of the structure and the framework of the page, and then the parts that are unique to you and the parts that are more difficult to load will sort of fill in afterwards. You know, your who's online will pop in afterwards. Your customized stuff will fill in. You know, the menu structure will go in first, and it fills in the parts. And so it seems like it loads really fast, but it actually probably takes 5 or 6 seconds for everything to load in.
So right now, if I understand correctly, you know, if you're going to a web page, you have to wait for everything to load typically before the page actually gives you anything.
Yeah, it's basically pretty much an all or nothing. There's some tracking code and a little bit of stuff that might load after, but to get all the graphics and everything, it's all basically compiled together, rendered, and then dumped out to the screen as well.
Okay.
So you have to wait for everything to load.
And this is going to be the ability to do it one at a time.
Yeah, and so the best part about that is you can cache parts of it then, because some things, the problem is like Facebook can't cache because it's unique to you. So everyone who goes to the page sees something unique. And so you can't cache or like save a static version because there's no version that applies to everyone or even to more than maybe a few people. So
okay.
So caching is not helpful. But caching is great. It's the sort of number one way to make things load fast. If you load, you know, Google search results or blog articles or something and they can load really fast, that's because they are cached. But that doesn't work with dynamic content, and e-commerce is filled with dynamic content.
So let's talk a little bit about dynamic content and what that actually means for e-commerce.
Stuff that's dynamic is stuff that is unique to you as the person who's viewing the site. So when it says, hello, you know, Shawn, that part's unique. No one else is this. Maybe people have the same name or whatever, but everyone's going to have their different personalized name that's going to show up. So that's dynamic content. We can't cache that for everyone. We have to load who you are as the user, and we have to bring that in. What's in your cart? That's dynamic. If you have special product recommendations that are unique to you, those are all dynamic pieces that are great in an e-commerce site, but they slow down the page loading because they have to be done for everyone, and we can't generate them in advance and then have a copy saved. So that's where the Bigpipe caching and the dynamic caching is really important, is because it gets you most of the things so you can see the products, you can start using the site, and then the extra bits that make it better pop in, but they don't delay everything.
Okay. And that just is going to improve the user experience, I'm assuming, right? The whole
Yeah,
the
because whole you get the site, it feels like you have the site load in like, you know, half a second, and then it actually takes a couple of seconds for this other stuff to pop in, but you still have lots of it there and you can start using the site. You have, you know, search results, you have the category there, and your customization sort of pop in as you're getting the sort of layout. You don't just have a blank white screen that you sit there and stare at for, you know, 3 seconds while it pops in.
So is there like a best practice then of for e-commerce for this, you know, in terms of what you determine to load first or load last or anything like that?
There's a few things you have to work around. Certain things might sort of be mandatory that you have to have load depending on what your page is like. But in general, you want to load the structure of the page.
Okay.
So you want to have it so that the background, the header, the footer, all that kind of stuff that stays the same loads in. So you have a page there, and then the content starts to populate in the middle. And if you can show some stuff at the top and then fill in other things, like, hey, let's show, you know, 6 products, and then we'll start to fill them in at the bottom. We don't need to load up 50 products right of the way, even though the page shows 50 products. You know, we don't need to, a perfect example would be we can show a button that says view cart, but we don't have to show what's in your cart or how many products are in there. It's nice to show that, but we don't need to prevent the page from loading while
we wait for that.
Yeah.
Got it.
It's not worth waiting on, and we can just pop it in, you know, a second later, because probably you look at the site and then you look back up at your cart. Mm-hmm.
So we've talked about this in the past. You grew up in the bush. You had dial-up internet for a long time, like into your 20s.
We're going to bring up sensitive things. And, so I was 17. I moved out when I was 17. Thank you, Steven.
Okay. Well, kicked out of the house, but we won't go there. And so up until that point, you had dial-up. Now, I remember having dial-up as well. And when you would load up a page, it would kind of load up pieces of the page, right?
Mm-hmm.
How is this any different? Like, hasn't that technology already existed? Like, why can't faster, you know, faster internet connections just load pages like that?
That was when it was doing back in dial-up. It was generating everything at once, and then it was literally just actually sending it to you that was taking a long time. Whereas what takes time nowadays is not the sending it to you, because everyone has broadband. It's really fast, even on your phone. You know, you have LTE, 4G kind of stuff. It's fast. So it's not the sending it to you that necessarily takes a long time. It's the building it. Drupal has to say, okay, or any CMS has to say, okay, you went to this page. What's all the stuff you need on that page? We need to load users, we need to load products, we need to load your cart, we need to check if you're logged in or not, we need to load all the content, and all this stuff has to happen. So it's not the sending it to you that takes a long time, it's the building it. Okay. And so we send you some stuff that we can cache and send you right away while we build that other stuff in the background. So it's not to save the downloading that you do, it's to save all the work that has to happen in the CMS. Because if we want to send you a page in under a second, there's a little bit of time in you trying to connect to the web server. So you have to send to the web server and say, I want this page.
Okay.
And then the server has to send back. And so that both takes up time. And so for actually building the page, we only get a tiny fraction of time that's outside of that. So to do a page load in under a second probably means we get 200, 250 milliseconds to actually load all the content, generate the whole page, and send it to you, because the other bit is used up in just sort of network latency. It's allowing us to have more time there while still sending us stuff right away, because instead of saying, hey, let's generate everything and then send it back, we start sending you stuff right away, and then we fill in the other pieces as we sort of generate them and come up.
And that can be decided through this feature, like in terms of what it is that you send first.
Yeah, and a lot of that is going to be basically determined automatically. You don't have to do a ton of configuration. It's going to say, okay, all this stuff, we know it's the same. It's not unique to an individual user. So we already have a copy of that saved. Just send that. We don't have to do any calculations. We just send it off. So that's something we can send immediately. We don't have to calculate it. And then we have the parts we have to calculate, and it sends those sort of as fast as it gets those.
Okay.
So you can get into a little more. You could prioritize those and stuff. But it's really just to get you something so the page can load up and you can start going and work on it. We can show, we'll throw up some really cool graphics, and we'll show how a page load can work when you get the whole setup in versus when you get pieces pop in. It's overall, like, the page will still take maybe 3-4 seconds to load, but the one will look usable so much quicker and will look so much faster, even though at the end it takes the same amount of time, but you just get content all while you're waiting for it to load.
So what happens when you actually get to the, like, billable part of e-commerce, when you're actually in your, you get through your cart, you're in your checkout now, does this all kind of go to the wash at this point?
No, so it's still, it doesn't maybe have quite as much effect, but you can still load the whole framework of the site, and it's just the internals that we show. So you'll still get the menu, the header, the footer, all that kind of stuff loads in, and then we just pop in the sort of checkout part up front. So it's great for carts, checkout, stuff like that. So you don't have that where you hit, next, and it takes 3-4 seconds.
It's like field one, field two, put your cart in here.
Yeah, well, or it takes, you hit next and you're like, did it do anything? And people click again and you have to worry about that kind of stuff. You get to the next page really quickly, and then it maybe takes a little bit before the fields populate in and you can do everything, but you know stuff is happening and you're most of the way there already, instead of just this sort of waiting, nothing's happening, you're bored kind of thing. So.
Okay.
So it's useful throughout the whole flow of e-commerce. It since Drupal Commerce isn't even finished, we haven't even sort of figured out all the ways that it's going to be useful.
Mm-hmm.
But the way the architecture works, all the way across the board for commerce, we should have really good speed improvement.
All right. So what's the kind of the too long didn't read of the caching bit here?
It's going to be fast as fuck.
Okay. Go for it. Oh, that was it. Literally,
that's
it's going to be.
That's too long didn't
that's
read.
It.
It's going to be fast as fuck.
I literally thought you were going to list it quickly.
No. Basically, your page load is going to take like half a second versus like 4 seconds. So it'll be really fast.
Got it. Why don't you go ahead and subscribe below. If you have a question or a comment, please do so below.
Follow us on Facebook. Follow our blog at ecommerce.com. Follow me on Twitter. I'm awesome.